And hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self, and today is day 67 of 99 Days, 99 Channels. The topic for today's session comes from a YouTube viewer who asks, daily dealing in a state of presence and love with the beloved 10,000 limited minds around our one. So I hope you all enjoy this session. Dear ones, you are the love eternal. You are peace. You are love. You are pure experience, existing as all life. All life, dear ones, without exception, without limitation. For it is the nature of reality, dear ones, to be all things, all time, all places. Yet it is, dear ones, your limiting mind that seeks to judge, that creates problems within your imagination, projecting these problems, dear ones, onto the neutral forms of this one consciousness. You believe the world to be different from you, so you create a feeling of separation within your consciousness, and you experience this separation throughout your waking life. The same is true, dear ones, with ideas of judgment, with all ideas of judgment that you place upon this very dear world. You call it different, you call it wrong, you call it up, you call it down, your mind calls it by all manner of things, but the truth, dear one, is that within this creation, within this sphere of experience, there are no true opposites. All of life is one integrated unit, changing form, changing appearance, all the while existing within totality as oneself. There is no separation. There is no your mind and the minds of others. There is only one field of consciousness in which all of forms exist. Yet as you choose, dear ones, to believe in your limited identity, you separate yourself out from this one consciousness. You separate yourself, dear one, and questions arise. How can I deal with the world that is separate from me? What can I do to change this world that is separate from me? How can I make myself better in this world? Do you see, dear ones, that all of your suffering comes from the idea of a separate self, comes from forming an identity within the unity of all that is, believing yourself to be different, believing yourself to have characteristics unique to that of other forms in manifestation. Yet the truth, dear ones, the truth will always remain that all of life is oneness. All of life can be experienced as this oneness without any division, without any separation, when you, dear ones, choose to drop your ideas of judgment, your ideas of limitation. But you say from your place of limited understanding, how can I still exist if all the world is one? How can I exist as a separate body if all of life is in fact one? And we say unto you, dear ones, it is only your judgment of your own perception, in which you perceive yourself to be separate, believing this form to be separate from all other forms, believing your consciousness to be separate from all other consciousness. A belief, dear ones, a belief that is influencing your experience of what life is. But when you choose, dear ones, to surrender this belief of separation, you will find that all the boundaries that you have created of who you think you are will dissolve. The dissolution will happen within your awareness, within your field of consciousness, and you will understand this experience directly. For that is where the truth lies, dear ones. It is not in the mind-made understanding of thoughts. It is not in philosophical inquiry or philosophical debate. This understanding, dear ones, is a pure, direct experience of what life is, of who you are. Words themselves can never grasp this experience of unity, where you no longer feel yourself or think yourself to be separate, but instead, dear ones, you realize yourself in this moment as direct experience, as the oneness of all that is. Throughout the apparent separation, dear ones, throughout this illusion of separation, you in fact are one consciousness. Yet the forms remain as appearance within this one consciousness. Yet your direct experience, dear ones, will be that of oneness, of pure and total unity. Without thoughts of separation, without thoughts of comparison, you will know yourself as one with all life. And thoughts of high and low, thoughts of better and less than, will no longer exist within your mind. You will no longer believe in the thoughts that create separation, for you will know your experience as direct truth, that all of life is oneness, that there is no separation, although the forms themselves appear to be separate. When in fact, dear ones, the space and the form are one manifestation as consciousness. It is an experience, dear ones, that words can only describe, yet words cannot convey. For you yourself must surrender your idea of who you think you are to begin to experience more deeply the fullness of your true being, the fullness of this one reality. Words, dear ones, are based upon comparison of who I am, who I think I am, in relation to what I think the world is. Can you see, dear ones, that you live within a world based upon the perception of your mind, based upon the thoughts that you have formed about what this world is, what this world is to you? To you, dear ones, through your mental filters. You believe the world itself to be truth. You believe your suffering to be the way it has to be the way it is. You say to yourself, well, everyone else experiences it, so why shouldn't I?